You had a ton of stolen bases in your minor league career. I mean, you had 55 in 2011. So you've had a lot of firsts this year.
Yeah.
How would it feel to get that first stolen base and kind of add it to the list?
It'd be cool. You know, it's definitely something that I feel like when I stole a lot of bases when I was younger, I came up with Cincinnati kind of coincidentally. I know we're playing them tonight, but they had a motto where they just wanted us to run in the minor leagues. And it was like, we're going to try to run, we're going to run, we're going to run, and we're going to try to learn from it. And as with anything in this game, kind of the more you move along, the smarter players are. The pitchers, you know, they start picking over. Catchers throw better. Guys are shorter the plate. So it's something that I've had to try to learn to be smarter about. And I know Molly likes to use it. And, you know, whenever he gives me the green light or the go-ahead, I'm going to hopefully be safe and get that first one.
I mean, I'm sure that'd be, I wouldn't say a sigh of relief, but when you were in the minor leagues, who was the guy that kind of taught you how to get that stepping stone from playing college and stealing bases in college to stealing bases in the pros?
Ken Griffey Sr. He was my first manager. Well, actually, he was my hitting coach my first year when I got drafted, and then he was the manager the next year. And he was awesome. He was like a father figure more so than a manager. He'd be there to pat you on the butt if you screwed up. He'd talk to you about it, and then he'd send you right back out there. And, you know, he was kind of the guy. He basically said, I don't care if you get thrown out. I don't care. I want you going in the first three pitches, and you're going to learn from your mistakes. And I felt like that was awesome. You know, in the minor leagues, you can afford to kind of learn from your mistakes more so than at this level. So, you know, here it's more of an exact science. And Molly, you know, of all the managers you could play for, I feel like that guy probably has the best clue on when to steal a base, how to steal a base. So I've actually gotten to work with him a few times, which is exciting. And, you know, hopefully the situation calls for it, and I'll be able to get to second or third base and, you know, hopefully score a run.
You were talking about how you started your career with Cincinnati. Was it 2011?
2011, yeah. Well, I got drafted in 10. 11 was my first year.
Right. When you were in the show and playing with guys that are on this team now, like Votto,
yep.
What was it like when you first got called up and you were around Votto, who is a Hall of Famer, I think, in everybody's mind? What did you learn from him?
You know, Joey, he was a good teammate. He, you know, he was always there. You know, he wasn't necessarily that vocal leader. It was more so lead by example, and kind of watching how he approached his business, how he approached hitting in particular was incredible. The things I saw him do in that might have been the year he hit 400 in the second half. And I mean, I think he had like 16 straight games where he was on base twice a game. And it was, you know, you just saw how he approaches at bats. And if he got to two strikes, it was guaranteed to either be a hit or a full count. He was not going to strike out before a full count. And just to see the discipline and him not give in to his approach and kind of how he approached pitchers was just something that I'll never forget.
So, like you said, you know, I can never forget. So have you brought those hitting approaches that Votto kind of, you know, I guess would land a little bit here and there? You play about 21 games or so, I'm assuming, right? I can look back in the stats-wise, but the games that you were up, have you kind of brought that hitting approach and the things you've learned from your days with Cincinnati to where you are right now?
Yeah, a little bit. You know, I feel like I've gotten a lot better as a hitter, a lot more mature. I learned a lot in Boston, actually, talking to David Ortiz and Pedroia and some of those guys. You know, I learned from them, too. I feel like you just try to take bits and pieces from kind of everywhere you've been. And, you know, even here watching guys like Miggy, Joe, Dozier, Eddie, I mean, all these guys have different approaches, different swings. And, you know, if you can find something that each of them do, you know, it's usually you can kind of throw it into a very small bucket. And it's there's very similar things that they do. So, yeah, I definitely, you know, I try to be my own hitter, but I definitely try to watch and observe what makes other guys successful.
And as of late, you've been playing a lot more.
Yeah.
Playing, like, getting chances in center and right, and you're in the lineup a lot more often. I know from playing, you know, the more you play, the more you get comfortable.
Yep.
How has that been for you so far?
Oh, it's been awesome. I mean, you know, I think, again, I get back to when I was first called up. You're a little more wide-eyed. You're a little more unsure of yourself. I think part of that's maturity. Part of that's being around the game a little bit longer. But, you know, this team especially from I mean, the front office to our coaching staff to the guys on the team, they make you feel so comfortable. And, you know, the more you get out there and when you start having success, you start realizing it's the same game. You know, you belong out here. you know, just like the Brian Doziers, the Joe Mauers, the Joey Vottos, you know, they're human beings too, and they happen to be very good at what they do, but you start to realize that you can play with them, and you know, that definitely kind of is a burden I think every young player has to overcome, but you can start to see it, you know, in some guys that they're growing up. So I feel like I've making some positive steps, but you know, I still got a ways to go, and I'm hoping to just keep getting better every day.